So no boating for us today. We are going to the pool. The two things you need to have in Florida is a boat and a pool. So our community has a pool, so we're gonna go up there, have some drinks and music, and chill.
Hi.
Nice. You right? Alright, I gotta head back to the house. We forgot the towels, so we're gonna go get the towels. I'm gonna get those towels, the new towels that my sister got us. Here we go. Take two. We got the towels. Let me see. Oh, that's warm. Drinks eye view here. There we go. Don't want my beverage too close. Don't want the security guard to come over and yell at us. She seems pretty cool though. Has she yelled at anyone yet?
I haven't seen her. I think I saw her approach a group. Remember? Yeah, there was a group of kids.
Yeah, she might have said something to them.
I forget what they were doing, but they were cool about it. They were like, oh, okay.
All right, so we're just chilling here at the pool still. Let's see what we got. Who wants spaghetti? Nobody wants spaghetti. Spaghetti? What is it like? Oh, you want some Chef Boyardee?
Spaghetti I make.
Let's see. There we go. Now it's recording. So the camera just powered off at the pool. It was too hot. So that happened to me the other day when I was doing my Clearwater Beach walking tour. About 14, 15 minutes in, the camera just powered off because it was too hot. So we are back here at the house.
Hi.
We're back here at the house, so we're gonna have a beverage, and then Kim is gonna go up to Publix to get the ingredients to make enchiladas. All right, so with our enchiladas tonight, we're gonna make guacamole. He's starting to turn a little bit red there. So yeah, he's ready for sure. So we got some jalapenos here. We're gonna pluck one of these and we're gonna use that to make the guacamole. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're gonna be making this delicious, savory, world famous guacamole. It's gonna be delicious. We use a molcajete to combine all the ingredients. I'll have the full recipe in the description box. But the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna rough cut your garlic, about 2 to 3 cloves. Next, you're gonna go ahead and slice up your jalapeno. You can use 1 to 2 of these depending on your spiciness level. This one was grown from our garden. It was fresh off the vine, so it really wasn't super hot. So put all these in your molcajete or your bowl. And then you're gonna kind of mash this into a paste. Next, you're going to go ahead and cut your avocados in half, remove the seed, and then scoop out the avocado. Take a lime, cut it in half. And we will use a juice of half a lime. Just pour that right in there. Pinch of sea salt. Now we're gonna rough cut some cilantro. Put that in there. And mix all this together. Now we'll be using some scoops. Give that a taste. Delicioso. Good stuff. Alright, so now we're going to start on the enchiladas. Kim bought a whole rotisserie chicken from Publix. You could get one of these from Costco or your local grocery store. Just go ahead and pick off all the meat. She did not put the skin in there. She put that to the side. And I was snacking on it. So we have some green chilies and some green enchilada sauce. She can be making two different versions. We have the Kraft Mexican cheese. The ingredients and instructions will be in the description box for this. So mix the cheese, your enchilada sauce, and the chicken. Make a filling. Then you're going to put this into the tortilla. We got two different versions going on here. One with the green chilies, one without. I had the red enchilada sauce. Now this recipe makes 10 servings. Then go ahead and pour the enchilada sauce on top of the enchiladas. Sprinkle on some more cheese. All right, now we put this in the oven, 350 degrees for 25 minutes. It's smelling good. All right, we're gonna pop these out. Let these cool a little bit because they will be piping hot. And go ahead and scoop these out. Kim made a little bit of yellow rice for hers on the side. All right, there's mine. Nom, nom, nom. That'd be looking good. And there you go, you got that easy chicken enchilada and that savory guacamole. Kim's was a little hot, breathing out all the hot air. I hope you've enjoyed this recipe and spending the day with us by the pool. Make sure to like, subscribe, leave a comment, and we'll see you in the next one.